Some of you may have heard that Kim Jong-un has reached out to Pope Francis. And in light of this, notice what the article says. This is New York Times. It says, Kim Jong-un invites Pope Francis to North Korea. It goes on to say that no pope has ever visited North Korea, whose totalitarian government cracks down on religious activities. The article goes on to say that Kim Jong-un, the leader of North Korea, which has been condemned as one of the worst suppressors of religious freedom in the world, has invited Pope Francis to visit his country, South Korea's government said Tuesday. And this is very significant, very much a fulfillment of Bible prophecy. Some of you have seen the video that we released yesterday stating how Pope Francis is fulfilling Bible prophecy. In that video, we showed how Pope Francis has entered nearly 40 countries just as Bible prophecy predicted that he would enter, or the papacy would enter into many countries. And we know that Revelation 13 and verse 3 says that the world would wander after the beast. So this is not surprising based upon what Bible prophecy has told us. But what is interesting to me is the question came to my mind as to why Kim Jong-un would invite Pope Francis. Why would this happen? And when we look at Bible prophecy, it gives us an idea. Notice what it says in Daniel 11, beginning in verse 40. Let us have a word of prayer. Loving Father, we ask for your Holy Spirit that you would please give us eye salve, give us the heavenly anointing that we might see how prophecy is fulfilling, how we can get ourselves ready by your power, by your strength, and overcome sin, self, before it is too late. Please bless us now that we may understand. In Christ's name, amen. Daniel 11 and verse 40, the Bible says, and at the time of the end shall the king of the south push at him, and the king of the north shall come against him like a whirlwind with chariots and horsemen and with many ships, and he shall enter into the countries and shall overflow and pass over. When we understand verse 40 correctly, we understand that France, which was an atheist nation, would come against the papacy and take the pope captive. That is what happened in 1798, which is the year for the time of the end. But in continuing the verse, it says, he shall come against him like a whirlwind with chariots and horsemen. Chariots and horsemen denote military strength. And when it says, and with many ships is talking about economic strength. Economics is what that is dealing with. The proof scriptures for that, for ships, you would write down Revelation 18, 17, Proverbs 31, 14, Psalms 107, verse 23. Shows us that ships is dealing with economic strength. And so this is the two means by which the papacy would come against the state government form of atheism, which is revealed in communism. Again, the government form of atheism is communism. And so when you understand coming against atheism, which is what France was revealed as, we know that the papacy would not come against France because France has united. We've already shown that in a separate video. But it would come against communism as a whole in the world. And this is what we're seeing. We saw it in 1989 when America united with the papacy to bring down communism. They used the Solidarity Movement to do that. And so notice what the Bible continues to say, speaking about how the papacy would come against communism. Notice what it says in verse 42. It says in Daniel 11, verse 42, he shall stretch forth his hand also upon the countries, and the land of Egypt shall not escape. Notice that, the land of Egypt. What is Egypt? Atheism. How do we know this? Exodus 5, verse 2. When Moses came to Pharaoh, he asked the question, you know, who is the Lord that I should let his people go? This was an atheistic frame of mind. Who is the Lord? Who is God? I don't believe there is a God. And so when we understand this Egypt term correctly, that is revealed in modern day atheism or modern day communism. And so the Bible tells us that the papacy would stretch forth his hand upon the land of Egypt. Notice what it says in verse 43. It says, but he shall have power over the treasures of gold and of silver and over all the precious things of Egypt. This is very significant. So over the economy of atheism, over the economy of communism, that the papacy would have control of their precious things. Remember, gold, silver, and the precious things represents economics, represents finances, represents trade. And so when we understand these things correctly, I believe the reason why Kim Jong-un is reaching out to Pope Francis is for his economy. His economy at this point is suffering due to the sanctions that have been placed upon them by America. Notice what this article reads. Notice what it says. It says, Kim Jong-un's economy could totally collapse within a year, North Korean defector says. Now, this article was published October 17th, 2017, almost exactly 1 year ago this article was published. And so the article goes on to say, North Korea's economy is on such thin ice, it could collapse within the next 12 months due to tough sanctions recently imposed by the United Nations after intense pressure from the Trump administration, a defector said Monday. And so when we look at the fact that now Kim Jong-un is reaching out to Pope Francis, I believe it is due to his suffering economy. And the Bible tells us that the papacy, who is the king of the north, would have control over the finances of the communist countries. The Bible makes that very clear here in verse 43. And so I believe in the coming weeks or months, if the details of their meeting is made public, and that's even if Pope Francis accepts it, but I do believe he will accept it based upon what Bible prophecy tells us here in verse 42 and verse 43. I believe Pope Francis will accept the invitation and he will go over. Now, if the details are made known, we'll know that the meeting was about the economics. If the details are held secret, it also confirms the fact that Rome or the Vatican, the papacy, is mystery Babylon, because if something is a mystery, that means a secret. That means the details are unknown, just as the meeting that the Vatican had recently with China in their secret deal, which we released a video about that a couple of weeks ago. Some of you have seen that video. But when you look at the term mystery and you look at the term secret, those are synonymous terms. And so she is truly mystery Babylon. She's working in secrecy. So hopefully the details will be revealed about their meeting, and we will see Bible prophecy fulfilling. So this is why this is so significant, that Kim Jong-un is inviting Pope Francis to come over to aid in the economic woes that North Korea is currently experiencing. In light of that, what does this tell God's people? What does that mean for you and I? Notice what it says in Daniel 11, verse 44. The Bible says, but tidings out of the east and out of the north shall trouble him. The him here is referring to the papacy, who was the king of the north, letting you and I know it is time to trouble the papacy. It is time to expose the man of sin and the fact that she is leading the world to break God's law in Sunday sacredness, and how God desires his true children at this hour to honor his seventh day Sabbath, which is Saturday. Let us move forward in our evangelism. Let us aggressively share the truth of what God has revealed concerning the papacy, concerning mystery Babylon, the whore of Revelation 17. Let us go forward in aggressive evangelism at this hour, investing all our means to forward the gospel, as God has called us to hasten the second coming of Jesus. Notice what it says in Revelation 18 as we close. Revelation 18 as we close. Notice what it says here beginning in verse 3. Revelation 18 and verse 3, the Bible says, for all nations have drunk of the wine of the wrath of her fornication, and the kings of the earth have committed fornication with her. Talking about Babylon, they've committed fornication with the papacy. The kings of the earth, that's talking about presidents, prime ministers, even individuals like Kim Jong-un. Notice what it says continuing. It says, kings of the earth have committed fornication with her, and the merchants of the earth are waxed rich through the abundance of her delicacies. Here the Bible makes it clear that even the merchants of the earth, that Babylon would be involved in the economics of society, showing us that truly, I believe this meeting that Kim Jong-un is calling is due to the economic woes of North Korea, and he desires to bring about some healing to his economic suffering. Therefore, he has reached out to Rome. Now, why would he reach out to Rome? If you do your research, no one is richer than the Vatican. No one is richer than Rome. She is richer than any country, richer than any corporation, richer than all the billionaires on the earth. No one's richer than Rome. And so since she has the majority of the world's wealth, it only makes sense for Kim Jong-un to reach out to Pope Francis under his current suffering condition in the economy of North Korea. So what does it mean for God's people? Verse 1 makes it very clear what you and I are to do. We are to call people out of Babylon now. Verse 18 and verse, chapter 18 and verse 1, Revelation 18 and verse 1, it says, and after these things, I saw another angel come down from heaven, having great power, and the earth was lightened with his glory. Brothers and sisters, God has exposed the falling of Babylon with the pedophilia and the homosexuality going on in the Catholic Church. This means it is time for us to evangelize. It is time for us to share the first, the second, and third angel's message. It is time for us to let others know that they are living in a judgment hour. And being that they're living in a judgment hour, their life is to be free from sin by the power of the gospel. And as they live this power of the gospel, they must separate from Babylon. Even those churches that are drinking the wine of Babylon, there must be separation. Therefore, we must call them out of Babylon. And as they come out of Babylon, they must embrace God's seven-day Sabbath, that they may be sealed in preparation to escape the seven last plagues, which are soon to fall after the mark of the beast. A national Sunday law is coming very soon to America, and every country of the world will follow suit, including North Korea, whom Kim Jong-un is president over. So, brothers and sisters, let us be about our Father's business. Let us get to work, because Bible prophecy is fulfilling. May God help us to be ready. Will you be ready to stand when Christ returns? Will you pass the judgment? Will you engage in a work for the Master, because time is almost up? May God help us to surrender all and invest our means, our finances, to finish the work that God has called us to do.